Let's see CPU scheduling concepts of operating system. So, what is mean by CPU scheduling? It is a process of determining which process will own a CPU for execution, while another process is on hold. CPU scheduling decisions may take place when a process either switches from running to waiting state, or switches from running to ready state, or a process switching from waiting to ready state, or it may get terminates. During these four scenarios, the CPU scheduling decision may be taken. Let's see the types of CPU scheduling. Majorly, there are two types of CPU scheduling. First one is preemptive scheduling and second one is non-preemptive scheduling. Let's see one by one in detail. To begin with, preemptive scheduling. When a process switches from running state to ready state or from the waiting state to ready state, the resources, mainly CPU cycles, are allocated to the process for a limited amount of time and then taken away. And the process is again placed back in the ready queue if that process still has the CPU execution time remaining. That process stays in the ready queue till it gets its next chance to execute on a CPU. Examples of preemptive scheduling are round robin, shortest remaining time first, priority, preemptive version, etc. Let's move to the non-preemptive scheduling. When a process terminates or a process switches from running to the waiting state, in that case, the scheduling type is termed as non-preemptive scheduling. In these scheduling, once the resources, that is CPU cycles, are allocated to a process, the process holds the CPU till it gets terminated. In the case of non-preemptive scheduling, it does not interrupt a running process in its middle of execution. Instead, it waits till the process completes its CPU burst time and then it can allocate the CPU to another process. Examples of non-preemptive schedulings are shortest job first, SJF, basically non-preemptive, and priority-based non-preemptive version of CPU scheduling algorithms. Now, let's see the difference between preemptive scheduling and non-preemptive scheduling. In case of preemptive scheduling, the CPU is allocated to the process for a limited amount of time. Whereas in case of non-preemptive scheduling, the CPU is allocated to the process till it terminates. In case of preemptive scheduling, the executing process is interrupted in the middle of its execution when higher priority process comes into the ready queue. Whereas in case of non-preemptive scheduling, the executing process is not interrupted in the middle of its execution and waits till its execution. In case of preemptive CPU scheduling, there is the overhead of switching the process from the ready state to running state and vice versa, and maintaining the ready queue. Whereas in case of non-preemptive CPU scheduling, no overhead of switching the process from running state to ready state. If a high priority process frequently arises in the ready queue, then the process with low priority has to wait for a long time. Whereas in case of non-preemptive CPU scheduling, if a CPU is allocated to the process having a larger burst time, then the process with smaller burst time may have to wait for a longer duration. In case of preemptive CPU scheduling, it provides flexibility by allowing the critical processes to access the CPU as they arrive into the ready queue, no matter what process is executing concurrently. In case of non-preemptive CPU scheduling, it is a rigid, as even if a critical process enters the ready queue, the process running CPU is not disturbed. In case of preemptive CPU scheduling, has to maintain the integrity of shared data. That's why it is cost associative, which is not the case of non-preemptive scheduling. Whereas non-preemptive CPU scheduling, cost is not at all associated. And lastly, in case of preemptive CPU scheduling, CPU utilization is high, whereas in case of non-preemptive CPU scheduling, CPU utilization is low. To summarize, in this video lecture, I have explained CPU scheduling and major types of CPU scheduling, followed by difference between preemptive and non-preemptive CPU scheduling types. The references that I have used. Thank you.